The Quran says, "Alhaakum al-takathur, hatta zurtum al-maqabir." You are busy piling up, calculating, developing your careers, your money, your occupation, your wealth, until you visit the graves. Think about it. When was the last time that you went to a funeral? Was it your mother? Was it your father? Was it your grandfather? Was it your uncle? Was it your cousin? Was it your friend? Was it your wife? Was it your husband? The last time that you visited the grave, when you went to a funeral and you saw that person whom you loved that was laughing, crying, live, boasting, wealthy, educated, denying, arrogant, whatever they were. What was the demeanor of the people when you walked in that funeral home, when that person was stretched out in their last suit? Were the people cracking jokes? Were they dancing? Were they clapping and singing songs? No. Silence. Melancholy. Trauma. Why? Because every person that walked in that room, seeing that person stretched out, the first thing they thought about was not the person. The first thing they thought about was that one day, this will be me.
Allah Azza wa Jal says, say the death that you are running away from, that you think you could escape from, فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ, you shall taste it. Then, ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ, then you shall return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot escape from death.
All of you are engaged in running your mouths, doing your business, multiplying, buying houses, cars, whatever you're doing. And when you're told about God, religion, life, morality, you're saying, look, I ain't got no time for that. I don't want to hear that. I don't even believe in God. Matter of fact, I don't even know if I'm going to die. And if I do, maybe I'm coming back again. As a matter of fact, science is so sophisticated that I think really that they're on the verge of being able to solve the whole thing of death soon. We ain't got to die. If we got enough money, we don't even have to die. See how arrogant people can be. Until they visit the funeral house. And then after you go to the funeral house, if you got the guts, you go to the grave. And now this is another scenario. And you say to yourself, is that it? I mean, 50, 60 years, scraping, struggling, scheming, lying, stealing, fornicating, jumping up and down, begging, working, and this is the end of it? I mean, is this what's gonna happen to me? Are they gonna be dropping me into a hole in the ground? A hole in the ground. So you and I, we're going into a hole, and all the people that's crying, screaming, pulling out the hair, almost acting like they falling in the thing with you. They want to just jump in there with you. Not really though, you know, it's all an act. Cause ain't nobody really gonna jump in there and stay in there. They don't love you that much. And then after all the shoveling, and honestly, I'm telling you, that's what they do. So after all the money and all the drama, and the people walk away from that grave, it's over. What about that person in the grave? What's happening? Because you know and I know that death is almost like sleeping. Your body is dead, your spirit is gone, but your consciousness is there. Your spirit is gone. You can't shout, you can't call out, you can't say, don't leave me here. But you're going to be hearing and you're going to be seeing, because that's a different kind of consciousness. But you can't move. And in that grave, this is when the real trauma is going to begin. You know, whenever people use the word death, they use it like in a whisper. You say, he died. We always use it like for somebody else. So the scenario of death doesn't really come to us. It doesn't really reach home. No, maybe, not some of you, not the poorest of you, not the weakest of you, but all of you will come through this process and then you will die.
Allah Almighty, He says, wherever you are and wherever you think you could escape to, Allah Azza wa Jalla says death can bring you. Don't think you could run away from Allah. You could run away from everyone except Allah. And you could run away from everything except death. Even if you were hiding in high towers, as Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Holy Quran, there is no escaping from that moment that Allah had ordained upon every single creation of His. You cannot increase 1 second of it. You cannot decrease 1 moment of it. We should always remind ourselves that we're not living in this dunya forever. That does not mean I neglect my dunya. But the amazing thing is, we live as we're never gonna die. As we're never gonna stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We live our lives as there's no judgment or reckoning. And death, my brothers in Islam, does not recognize, does not know young or old. Death comes to everyone. When the time comes, it comes to you. So what have you prepared? Why have you prepared for this moment that you don't know when you're going to die and you don't know where you're going to die?
فقد فاز وما الحياة